We want to get back to our breaking news now. The breaking news out of Israel. Attackers went after a bus, assaulted an Israeli military force, and even targeted another vehicle in the city of Eilat. That's near the Egyptian border in the southern part of Israel. At least five people critically wounded. Jerusalem Bureau Chief Kevin Flower joins us live now from Jerusalem. Give us an update on who might be responsible for this.
Well, at this point, the Israeli government is laying blame for the incident on Gaza, on militants from the Gaza Strip. The defense minister here, Ehud Barak, released a statement in which he said the origins of this attack came from the Gaza Strip, while at the same breath holding Egypt responsible for allowing terrorist elements to expand in the Sinai Peninsula. So connecting the dots here from this statement, it would suggest that the Israeli government believes that some militants crossed from the Gaza Strip into Egypt, into the Sinai Peninsula, and then crossed back into southern Israel to carry out these attacks. And this is a quickly developing story. Let me just update you on some of the facts here. What we know at this point is that at least five people have been killed in that attack. So over two dozen have been injured. And what the Israeli military is saying happened is that it was actually four different attacks carried out by multiple terrorist attackers, they say. The first one was an attack on a bus. This happened slightly after noon. The second attack was a roadside bomb that targeted a military vehicle that was responding to the site of that first attack. Then there were mortars fired across the border from Egypt into southern Israel. And then finally there was the firing of an anti-tank missile on a vehicle in southern Israel. So this is a very complicated, widespread attack. The details of it are still emerging at this point, but clearly Israeli policymakers and security officials are greatly worried about what this means for the future.
Kevin,
I'm sorry. I just wanted to update. We're getting information from all over the place, Kevin. CNN has now confirmed six are now dead. I just wanted to ask you, is it unusual in this particular part of Israel for these types of attacks to happen?
It's not unusual. Just in April of this year, there was actually an attack against a bus, a similar bus, a public bus, a school bus, in fact, and that was an attack by an anti-tank missile fired from the Gaza Strip. Now, that didn't involve as many injuries and as many dead as this attack here, so it is not unheard of. But for the past few years, I mean, by and large, it has been quiet in southern Israel. There, you know, for the past 4 to 5 years, there have not been the same number of attacks in Israel that we saw earlier at the beginning of the decade, 2000, 2001, those first couple of years. So this is really going to have people worried that there is some sort of return to some sort of lawlessness, not lawlessness, but concern primarily about that southern border with Egypt and lawlessness in the Sinai Peninsula, basically allowing for elements to cross the Israeli-Egyptian border. And that's where all the questions are going to be coming for Egypt and for the Palestinian government as well.
I also wonder, you know, Hosni Mubarak no longer is the leader of Egypt. Would this have anything to do with this renewed violence in this particular part of Israel?
It's really hard to speculate at this point. I mean, what we do know about what's going on in Egypt at this point is just this past week, the Egyptian military sent in additional forces to carry out operations against what it called al-Qaeda elements. Now, this is a very stunning development, really, in a lot of ways, because basically what we've seen in the Sinai Peninsula is a breakdown of law and order there since the Mubarak regime fell. And basically what's had to happen is the Israeli government has essentially had to give permission to the Egyptian government to send in those additional troops because of the treaty, the peace treaty that governs the Sinai Peninsula. So the Egyptians and the Israelis, to a certain extent, have been working together to try and combat some of the, you know, some of this activity in the Sinai Peninsula. But it's clearly still going to be a source of concern going forward. And it's noticeable that the defense minister pointed the finger directly at Egypt in his statement.
Kevin, when we talked last, you said that there was some reporting that there was a gunfight underway, that there might have been another attack. What are we looking at? Are we looking at two attacks or three attacks? And have we got confirmation that that is over now?
Well, we don't. It's really still developing. I can We've sort of gone over the facts, and here are some of the different reports out there. We know from the Israeli military spokesman that there were at least four different attacks. What we don't know is how many attackers were involved in this. The Israeli military is suggesting that it was multiple attackers, more than one team. Based on the information they're giving us, this would seem to be the case, because these were attacks that were happening within a close proximity of each other, but at roughly the same time. This is a fairly sophisticated attack, using anti-tank weapons, improvised explosive devices within Israeli territory. This is not likely the work of one or two people. It is likely that a number of people were involved in this. And this is an area in southern Israel. This is within its territory that is patrolled by the Israeli military. So it is a very, very serious attack, and Israel is going to be quite concerned about it.
All right, Kevin Flower for us in Jerusalem. Thanks so much, Kevin.